बठिंडा केस ऑफ एसोसिएट बिल्डर्स दिस कोर्ट हैड एन ओकेजन टू कंसीडर इन डिटेल द ज्यूरिसडिक्शन ऑफ द कोर्ट टू इंटरफेयर विद द अवार्ड पास्ड बाय द आर्बिट्रेटर इन एक्सरसाइज ऑफ पावर्स अंडर सेक्शन 34 ऑफ द आर्बिट्रेशन एक्ट. In the aforesaid decision, this court has considered the limits of power of the court to interfere with the arbitral award. It is observed and held that only when the award is in conflict with the public policy in India, the court would be justified in interfering with the arbitral award. In the aforesaid decision, this court considered different heads of public policy in India, which inter alia includes patent illegality. After referring section 23 of the Arbitration Act and after considering the decisions of this court in the cases of M. Dermot International versus Burn Standard Cooperative Limited and Rashtri Ispat Nigam Limited versus Diwan Chandram Saran, it is observed and held that an arbitral tribunal must decide in accordance with the terms of the contract. But if an arbitrator constitutes a term of the contract in a reasonable manner, it will not mean that the award can be set aside on this ground. It is further observed and held that construction of the terms of a contract is primarily for an arbitrator to decide unless the arbitrator constitutes the contract in such a way that it could be said to be something that no fair-minded or reasonable person could do. It is further observed by this court in the aforesaid decision in paragraph 33 that when a court is applying the public policy test to an arbitration award, it does not act as a court of appeal and consequently errors of fact cannot be corrected. A possible view by the arbitrator on facts has necessarily to pass rule as the arbitrator is the ultimate master of the quantity and quality of evidence to be relied upon when he delivers his arbitral award. It is further observed that thus an award based on little evidence or on evidence which does not measure up in quality to a trained legal mind would not be held to be invalid on this score. Applying the law laid down by this court, we have to examine whether the decision bench of the High Court has exceeded in its jurisdiction in here now. For convenience, we shall deal with the impugned judgment and order passed by the High Court claim wise. The first claim is with respect to price adjustment escalation. The second claim is with respect of fixed cost and the third 44 claims is with respect to escrow account. Now, so far as the claim with respect to price adjustment escalation is concerned, the learned arbitrator held that the date of commencement of the first operating year for the purpose of clauses 52 read with 54 would be 25 June 2011, and therefore 0 year for the purpose of price escalation has to be 2011-12. Accordingly, the learned arbitrator considered the escalated price in financial year 2003-14 at Rs. 900 per MT. However, according to the respondent, as the date of commencement was changed and the 0 year for the purpose of price escalation would be 2003-4, it is required to be noted that it is not in dispute that price escalation is permissible under the contract or agreement itself, and there shall be price escalation every year as per the formula mentioned in the agreement commencing from the date of commencement. However, it is true that the initial date of commencement, that is 25 June 2011, came to be extended to 25 March 2013 by mutual agreement. However, the same was due to force majeure, as there was a delay of 21 months in obtaining the forest clearance and environmental clearance. The price was quoted in the year 2007-8, applicable from 2011. However, there was a delay in obtaining the forest clearance and environmental clearance, and therefore the date of commencement of supply came to be changed. In between, there would be hike in labor charges, transportation charges, etc. Though the date of commencement of supply was extended, there was no corresponding amendment in the relevant clauses of the agreement with respect to price escalation. There was no specific agreement that in the year 2013 the appliant would supply the coal at the same price without any price escalation. Therefore, considering the overall facts and circumstances of the case and by giving cogent reasons, the learned arbitrator interpreted the relevant clauses of the contract and specifically held that the date of commencement of the first operating year for the purposes of clauses 52 read with 54 would be 25 June 2011 in the case.